What is up, guys, and welcome back to a brand new video. Today we've got a special one because we are driving around Bahrain. Not just any Bahrain, the Oval Circuit. That's not clickbait. There is an actual Oval Circuit layout within the Bahrain International Circuit layouts, whatever. So we're going to be doing that, and we're also going to be doing the outer layout, which we're racing at in F1 this weekend. So two races, two videos in one. Smash a like button, subscribe, and we'll get into it. But it's been a pretty crazy year for F1 with all the track changes, the back-to-back races, Bahrain being, you know, one of those that's doubling up this season. But also the driver transfers as well, with drivers falling ill, what have you. You know, the likes of Sergio Perez and Lance Stroll, Nico Hülkenberg of the world stepping in. This weekend in particular, it's been pretty crazy for announcements. Driver swaps all over the place. You know, Jack Aitken jumping into the Williams, replacing Russell. Russell replacing Hamilton. And then Pietro Fittipaldi replacing Grosjean, unfortunately, after that massive crash last week. Let's hope that he can recover quickly. And so too with Lewis Hamilton as well. Be good to see him back for the finale in Abu Dhabi. But we're talking about Bahrain, and we're actually going to be doing the Oval Circuit. So let's get into it now. We're in the Mercedes ourselves, and we're going to see how quickly we can find our way to the front from the back, doing this oval layout. So this will be interesting, to say the least. Here we go. Always sounds so good, this car in a Assetto Corsa. Six red lights, and we are underway. And as you would expect, absolutely shocking start from me. So off we go, down into turn one. Let's see what Bahrain's oval circuit looks like. We cut in through the AstroTurf for turn one, I think. And we're now driving up the access road. That's the middle sector straight on our left-hand side. And then we cut in to the final corner, basically. And we're back on the start-finish straight again. And that is essentially Bahrain's oval layout. But it's so cool. There's so many layouts that it actually takes up an entire page of different variations in Assetto Corsa's track list. It's pretty mad, as we nearly got overtaken by the AlphaTauri through that little kink there in the slipstream of the Renault. These laps are going to go by like a flash. I didn't see how fast or slow the last one was, but we're probably looking at about 30 seconds for the outer layout, which we're going to do next. That's probably about double that, just under 60 seconds, I would say. But yeah, this is 2020, eh? Nothing surprises me anymore. I can't tell if I've got DRS or not. I am getting slipstreamed to all. Oh my! Whoa, 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 whoa! Someone was upside down there. Someone was upside down. Sergio Perez has retired. Wow, that's there was a Racing Point upside down last week. It's pretty mad. Anyway, I look away for a second and all hell broke loose down into that corner. Assetto Corsa is a funny old game when it comes to the AI behavior and stuff. They just, for the life of them, can't get through certain corners. Oh, speak of the devil. Here we go, up the inside of many drivers. Don't know what position I'm in now, but here's Valtteri Bottas. Whoa! Oh dear. Imagine Jack Aitken and George Russell crashing this weekend in each other's cars. Anyway, leaders on the last lap. What lap are we on? I don't even know. I think I've probably got another lap to go. We're down in P16 or something like that. I'm really keen to see how George Russell gets on this weekend. I think, in my opinion, it's a win-win, or possibly a lose-lose for Bottas. If he gets thrashed by Russell in his first weekend, then that's a massive yikes. But even still, if he beats Russell, then, you know, who cares? It's Russell's first outing in a top car. But Russell can only impress, really, especially at a track like this. But that was the Oval Circuit. It was pretty manic, I'm not going to lie. We ended up way down the order, P16. Yeah, that massive crash didn't help things. We were ahead of Bottas. We were fighting with Bottas for a few seconds there. So we very nearly could have won that race if I didn't bottle. But there you go. All right. Now it is time for the outer layout, which I haven't done a single lap of. And as well, hand on my heart, I haven't seen a single lap of it either, which way the circuit goes. So this is going to be a bit of a learning experience for both of us. So let's get into it. The feature race, if you will, of this video, outer layout. Can we find our way to the front? It is lights out, and away we go with smoke absolutely everywhere as we head down into turn one. Some drivers willing to push it a little bit more than others. We'll see how it goes. Bit of a crunch there with the AlphaTauri and the Racing Point. Oh, contact, and he's gone. The undulating bit looks a lot different on this game than in F1, that's for sure. Down into turn four. This is all still very familiar. It's about to go different now. We go left instead of right. My phone's going off. I'm busy bee. Hello, phone. Through the S section. I don't know how much speed to carry through here. This is all a bit odd. Oh, and that's it. That's it. That's the layout. Just the chicane. Just the chicane. That's all I need to learn. How much speed to take in and learn the braking point for that. And we should be good. Down into the last corner. Looks way different. So much different to real life. I mean, not real life. It looks so much. Yeah, it looks different to real life, but it looks way different to the F1 game as well. Oh, threading the needle. Threading. Turn. I swear this car can't turn when someone else is glued to you. Nice physics. Concentration faces on. Oh, this is the little left, I think. Is that the section? Oh, yeah, we go right. So that's part of... I've actually done that before. It's from F1 2010. That's part of the endurance layout. We do that chicane, and then there's a right. How did I not realize this sooner? To be fair, that's only my second lap around the circuit. So there we go. Maybe some people didn't pick up upon that at all. Anyway, open the DRS again. We're in P10, I want to say. P11. Outside line, down into turn one. Everyone getting a bit feisty. Goodbye, Carlos. Ejecto cedo, cuz. Hit Daniel Ricciardo in that ASAP. I'm just going to cut over this AstroTurf. Thank you very much. And we'll be on our merry way. Oh no, guys. Carlos Sainz retired. I can't believe it. Must have been a mechanical issue. Reliability. Whew. I can't imagine he got taken out. Who would do such a thing? But anyway, I'm starting to get into this race now. We're on the penultimate lap. And I really find it so clunky, these cars, to push. As soon as you step on the limit, it really swaps from underneath you. Down to 18th place. That's a big yikes. Big lunge. Whoa! Just understeer when I turn in there. There's another version of this car. I think it's the ACL version. And it feels way nicer than this car does. I can push it straight away. There's just something about whatever settings I've got on this car that just makes it impossible to feel comfortable. Maybe that's just me. But, yeah. Anyway, oh! Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. The car just feels very stiff and it doesn't feel like it's got much mechanical grip at all. That's my problem with this car and this setup. But down into the last corner. People are going defensive. We might be able to get someone on exit. Come on. Come on. Edging the car forward. Let's open the DRS. Up to the line. Where's the line? This might be the line. It is the line. Wait, this is the last lap. We got one more. Never mind. I don't know what I was playing at. Obviously, the game takes into consideration when the leader crosses the line. So, when I saw that 4 out of 5, I was still on lap 3. That's embarrassing. So, there's been many embarrassing moments on the channel. Countless times where I've lost count of how many laps there are to go. and kind of given up, so to speak, after the on the race when the race is on its last lap, thinking it's over. But this one ain't over just yet. We're gonna switch to the inside. Yes, and get both of them. Lovely stuff. I think we've just been undercut. No, we haven't. We got them both. And up to the line. Where does that... That's eighth place! Come on! Get in there. We came back from the back, essentially, twice to get points in under five laps. I will take that. Guys, that's been this video for today. Hopefully you enjoyed. Leave a like if you did. Subscribe to the channel if you need to see plenty more racing game content. On F1 2020, Assetto Corsa. I don't know if I mentioned it or not, but if you want to see an actual oval race on like a US oval circuit with slip streaming and stuff, let me know and I will make that happen. But enjoy the racing this weekend. I am supremely excited for it. It's probably one of the most anticipated Grand Prix I'm going to watch in a long time, simply because of all the driver moves and what it might mean for their future. But that's it from me today. Until the next one, I'll see you next time.